Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to show you how to load the data, loading JSON data into a relational table. This is the fifth video from Snowflake data loading playlist. Here if you see, this is the data from the sales.json file where we have a three records. Location details, we have a state, city, zip and sales data and price. So sales date, so total we have a 1, 2, 3 columns. Within that three columns, here state and city is the one column and zip inside. Okay, these are the location outside fields. So now after loading the data, our data should data from the relational table after loading like this: city, zip, state, type, sales date, price. What is the price? So this is our expected output from the sales after loading the data into relational table by using the copy command. In this process, I am going to use these functions to achieve the expected output. So the first function, substr or substring, this is the built-in function provided by the Snowflake. What it will do, inserts different portions of a string element into multiple columns. Suppose if you have a one string, you want to split into multiple parts and insert into the multiple columns. In that case, we will prefer the substring or substr, both are same only. And the other function, parse underscore JSON, this will interprets an input string as a JSON document. The other function, two underscore timestamp or two underscore timestamp star, which is a conversion function. What it will do, it casts a string element to timestamp underscore integer data type. Basically, this will convert a string into a timestamp format. Now let's start demo. As I said that this is the file. Okay, to load this file, here I am going to use the Snowflake named internal stage. So that I will do. So before loading the data, let me show you the data from the table. Okay, I already did this one. So this is the expected data. So after loading data from the JSON file into the relational table, the expected output would be like this. Now what I am going to do, see, to download this data file, here is the link. I will provide this link in the description. Okay. Yeah. So to do this, I am going to use the role account admin and database is the demo underscore DB. Schema is the public. I have to create a table to store the data, relational table. So create a replace table, home underscore sales and city, zip, state, type, string, default. I mean, if you don't have anything, then default will take it as a residential, and sales underscore data underscore timestamp integer and price string. Because I think if you see the, if you observe the JSON file, the type field is not there like a residential or something. So we are considering the entire data hard coded as a, this is a sales related residential data only. That's why we are not going to use as part of this column while copying the data into relational table. So default value should be residential. Okay, now created the table. So let me see the table, because earlier data is there, so it should truncate because we have created create a replace table. Hence it should, so I didn't create the table. So let me create table. Yeah, table home underscore sales successfully created. Now if you see the data, it should be zero records because we have created and replaced the table. Okay, now let me create a file format. This file format is a field delimiter none, because if you don't specify any, you know, delimiter, then it will take default as a CSV file. So to avoid that, I am going to use the, you know, we are to use the none. That means it will not consider any type as the CSV or whatever it may be, because here we are dealing with this JSON file. We know not required any file format, and the record delimiter is // and new line, because we have a three lines. So each line, how that end with the line by using the new line carriage return. Okay, now let me create a stage here. This is the Snowflake internal named stage. Here name is the sf_tut_stage. So file format is equal to whatever that file format just now we have created in the this. I am using that one while creating the stage. So in Snowflake we have a two types of stages. One is the external stage, another one is the internal stage. In the internal stage, we have a different types of internal stages are there. The first one is the, you know, table stage, user stage, and Snowflake named stage. In Snowflake named stage, we have a temporary also we can create, but this is the permanent table. We are not specifying any temporary keyword. If you specify the temporary keyword, then that stage will, you know, specific to that session only. Okay, now we have to place the our JSON file into this stage. So to do that, we have to use the put command. So put command will not, please note that put command will not work in, okay, from Snowflake web UI. So what we have to do, we have to use the SnowSQL utility. SnowSQL utility is the command line from interpreter where you can copy the file from your local system into Snowflake internal stage sf_tut_stage. So here this is the syntax to put the file into internal stage. Let me go to command prompt, and then this is the where, I mean, to connect to our Snowflake. So SnowSQL -a for the account and -u is the, you know, user. So let me log into Snowflake database by using the user Venkat, and okay, now it will prompt the password. Let me enter password. Okay, yeah, so here the moment when you connected here, you know, user is Venkat, and you know, this is the default virtual warehouse, and here there is no database and no schema. So let me set the database and schema so that, you know, what wherever we created all other objects, there only we have to place the this file. So use database demo db, use schema public, copy the file. Let me set the role also. Use role account admin. Okay, now let me paste the command put syntax here. If you see, yes, file has been copied into our stage. Now if you want to display that one by using the list command, you can list at the rate sf_tut_stage. So this list command, you can execute this list command from web UI also. Okay, so let's jump into our web UI. So now we will check from here, list at the rate, what is our stage name? This is our stage name. You see, this is the stage name, and we have a, sorry, this is the file name under this, and we have a, this is the MD5 unique, I mean, you know, this is the file for to identify the whether same file exists or not from that stage. Now what are we going to do? We have to load the JSON data into our relational table. So here relational table name is the home_sale by using the copy command. Copy into table name. here we are using only these columns, and please note that type column not using, because that is the default is the residential. That's why we are not specifying here. The reason we don't have that type of data from the file. Hence, okay, here see, after specifying the columns from, we have to write a selected. Please note that we are using our functions, built-in functions, as part of the copy command. Okay, in that case, there are, I mean, all built-in functions will not support as part of the copy into command. So there are few functions only support while copy into command. So that I will do another video, what are all commands will support as part of the copy into command. So now here the parse underscore json dollar one is the, it will read the entire line into a one string. So from there we have to extract the whatever our data based on the file. In the file we have a location, in the location states city. So here we are taking the fourth letter onwards. Okay, and substr parse underscore json dollar one location state city, one to first character and second character, one to two characters only we are taking. Like that we are taking the other values, we are taking entire, because we are splitting from one field to two columns. From file we have a file level, we have only one column, but in the relational table we are going to inserting to the two columns by splitting the data to two columns. And here on error is equal to continue, I am going to use the on error is equal to continue. So here on error clause will take the different copy options. Okay, on error, continue, skip file, skip underscore file underscore num, skip underscore file underscore num percentage, and abort statement. So here continue means what it will do, continue loading the file. Okay, copy statement returns an error for the maximum of one error for each file. Suppose here we are going to load only one file, but if you have a multiple files and if you use the pattern kind of thing, you know, json star or file sales under sale star like that, then if you have a multiple files, then for each file it will check the one error. If more than one error, then it will fail. So that is the one option. If you use the skip file, then if you see any error, then it will just simply skip that file and continue with the rest of the files. And the other option, skip underscore file underscore num, that means how many errors, I mean maximum errors, if you exceed maximum errors, say example if you specify the skip underscore file underscore 10, then it will, if exceeds the more than 10 records, then it will terminate. Okay, same, instead of number you can specify the percentile also. Like, you know, in your table, I mean in your file, assume that there are 200 records, and then if you specify the 6%, then 12 records it will, if it exceeds more than 12 records, then it will fail. And abort statement, it will abort if any error occurred in the files. And please note that if you run with your copy command without any file into your stage, then it will not abort. It will come, loading process will completely successful, then you will see the zero rows processed successfully, like that kind of message. Now let me execute this copy into command. Okay, so yeah, see, if you see here file, what the process here, okay, sales and sales.json underscore gz. So this is the, when you copy file into the Snowflake internal stage or Snowflake stage, then automatically it will zip the file, and status is the loaded. That means our process completed. And number of rows parsed is the 3 rows, as I showed you that, you know, in our JSON file having 3 rows. So 3 rows parsed and loaded. How many loaded files? 3. And the error limit we set as the 3, and the other column is the error seen. We didn't have any error records, that's why here 0. Okay, these are the necessary information. Please note that each line, okay, each row we may have a multiple errors also. So to check that multiple errors, there is a one more function called, I mean, table function validation. With that, you can get the all the errors related to particular row. Okay. So now let me execute, I mean, query the data from the relational table. Okay. So let me code this one. Okay, three rows. This is the expected output. Please note that this type is the, you know, default value. This value not present in the our JSON file. So in JSON file, this city and state are in one column. So here we extracted into the two columns by using the one of the function substring substr function. And if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe and don't forget to click on bell icon for the notifications. Please share it and like it. Thank you once again for watching my video.